The Supreme Court issues a split decision on an Indiana pro-life law, refusing to rule on the state's ban of abortions due to an unborn child's sex, race, or disability. But the court does allow one part of the law, signed by then-Governor Mike Pence, to go into effect. Capitol Hill correspondent Jason Calvi has details. Good evening, Jason.
Good evening, Lauren. It's an unusual 7-2 decision skirting around the topic of abortion. The Supreme Court overruled an appeals court. That means Indiana can require the remains of unborn children to be buried or cremated. Those bodies can no longer be treated as infectious medical waste, like used needles. However, today the court avoided a decision on another part of this law.
The Supreme Court today punts on whether Indiana can ban abortions due to the unborn child's sex, race, or disability. Justice Clarence Thomas writes, enshrining a constitutional right to an abortion based solely on the race, sex, or disability of an unborn child, as Planned Parenthood advocates, would constitutionalize the views of the 20th century eugenics movement. Pro-life Hoosiers lobbied for the Dignity for the Unborn Act.
And really, today's decision is a microcosm of how the whole Roe versus Wade framework is on a collision course with itself, because you can't say on one hand that these children who are aborted are, they do contain dignity, so we can't throw them out as trash, but on the other side say we're not going to address their civil rights.
A collision driven at the state level.
Abortion is a human right.
Alabama's governor this month signed a ban on mostly all abortions.
From a purely personal point of view, my faith tells me that life begins at the moment of conception. And I think Roe versus Wade was totally wrongly decided.
This law challenges Supreme Court precedent, and the ACLU already sued.
The governor admitted that it was unconstitutional. Their sole hope is to get back to the U.S. Supreme Court on the hope that the change in its makeup will undo the last 40 plus years of established precedent.
Also challenging that, states like Ohio.
It is law.
And Mississippi. Recently passing bans as soon as the heartbeat is detected.
Other states like New York are enshrining abortion. Now, the Supreme Court today says it's following its normal practice. That's, they're waiting for more appeals courts to rule on the substance of the case. Justice Clarence Thomas says the court cannot wait forever. And Vice President Pence, who signed this law when he was governor of Indiana, says he hopes someday protections from discrimination based on sex or race or disability will also be applied to unborn Americans. Lauren?
Capitol Hill correspondent Jason Calvi. Thank you, Jason.